All right, so this is where we are, right? So we have recognized so far that these are the various phases in an SDLC.
Right.
Okay, so I'm just writing something here. These are the various phases of SDLC. One is first, very first thing, like at a program level, the thing, you know, what should be done? We want to get there strategically for the company. What should we really do? Okay,
right.
Then they plan. Then they go through a feasibility study, then they do the requirement gathering, then they do the design, then they do development, then they do testing of the software, then they do training for the software, deployment, then maintenance enhancement. But what this is all about? So obviously we all know that there is a software, an IT department, the IT department of the company is making a software for the sales department,
right?
IT department consists of these. So this is the IT department,
right?
And this IT department uses this thing to make the software for who? This is the company's hierarchy.
Right.
So these guys in the IT department, in the whole IT department, this is where I have written, this is information technology department.
Right.
They are helping the sales department,
right,
by making a software for them. So they are making a software. This department, IT department, is making a software for the sales department.
Right.
Typically, VP of sales will allocate a budget like $50 million for a sales application and so on and so forth.
Right.
Why do salespeople need an application? Let's try to understand that now.
Right.
Customers, these are all our customers.
Right.
Okay, they are accounts. There are people who are dealing with us, who are dealing with these sales reps, these reps.
Right.
There are these sub accounts in which basically, let's say there is a parent company, like for example, GE. And their children companies are GE Rail, GE Consumer Goods, and things like that. So if you recognize all that, there are companies within companies, there are divisions of these companies who might be dealing with us, there might be sites of these companies who might be dealing with us, any of these things. These deal with us, and then they have assets which they bought from us. They are also lying somewhere outside. They don't belong to us.
Right.
They belong to someone else. These salespeople help them. Within this sales organization, this is the sales organization. Similarly, there is a service organization. We sometimes call it service organization. Sometimes we can call it service department. Same thing.
Right.
This is not Siebel World organization. This is just American English World organization. Okay,
right.
I'm just changing it to service department to leave the confusion apart. Similarly, this is sales organization. This basically means department. All these basically need a system to work. This sales department and this service department, all these guys need a system to do their work so that they can sell to these guys better. There are so many people outside whom they want to sell.
Right.
Actually, these are huge in number. There is no one customer. There are like millions of accounts, million of companies out there whom they would want to sell to.
Right.
This will be typically like 800, 900 in number, you know, sales reps, you know, spread across United States trying to sell stuff to these accounts.
Right.
And here within the company, within Yahoo or within, let's say, wherever you're working,
right,
this will be a team of people making a system for them.
Understand.
The relationship between these guys and these sales representatives is the same as, for example, let's say these sales reps need a pen. Somebody has to give them the pen within the company.
Right.
So within the company, there will be a department, which will stationary department, which will give them the pen.
Exactly.
If they need a car, they will book the car. Similarly, if they need a system, they will come to the IT department. I have written it here.
Right.
Okay. So they will come to this IT department.
Right.
So this IT department is the one which will give them the system or the software. So this is the relationship between these departments and this IT department.
Right.
They will at that point think whether they need a system or they don't need a system.
Right.
Okay. So this is a very big level discussion. And when you join as a business analyst, this discussion would have already been over.
Most likely.
Yes. And typical time frame is they keep on deciding all these things. This is an everyday thing. But typically for your purpose, I would say it's like goes for like 2 to 3 months. They
right.
just keep deciding what to do.
Right.
at some point of time, they will decide either we will not go with the system. If they don't go with the system, of course, the next phases will not come.
Right.
If they go with the system, then the next phases will come.
Right.
First is they will appoint a project manager.
Right.
That project manager will do a number of things. He will, at that point, start planning the software, planning this, the whole project, the
right.
whole project of creating this software
system for sales people.
As part of planning, this is how, what they will do is, at mainly they will determine a very high level scope.
They will be determined at a very high level.
Yeah. With very high level, I'm basically planning is not again what you will be doing.
Uh-huh.
It will be done by project managers.
Right.
I'm just trying to say at a very high level, they will have an idea that we will go with account management and content management, but we will not do any opportunity management. Or we
yes.
will not touch our service department. They will not get benefit from this project. We'll only come roll out a system which benefits sales department in terms of accounts, contracts, and opportunity management. Or they might say, no, we don't want to help our sales department. We want to help our marketing department only. So it will have lead functionality, lead management, and call lists management, and calling management, and things like that. But it will not, after the lead is generated, we don't want this system to be used.
Right.
They can think in terms of multiple things to determine what kind of business system is required.
Right.
And this is the very high level scope that they will make. This will be at a very high level, like really saying that we need account management and these are some of the features that we will need.
Right.
Okay. At some point of time, they start doing feasibility study. They
right.
will start evaluating various softwares. They
right.
will evaluate various out-of-the-box softwares, you know, sold by other companies. They will also evaluate whether if we make a homegrown application, will that be better or not. They do budgeting here. Various out-of-the-box systems are evaluated versus homegrown systems, you know, whether we should make it at home or not. They do many things here as part of this whole exercise.
Right.
They go through budgeting. They do budgeting. They think, you know, this is the scope that we need. They go through the systems, features of the system that they need, like
right.
what are the various features they need.
Right.
And then they compare these various options, like various, like they could go for Siebel, they could go for SAP CRM, they could
right.
go for Kana CRM, Clarify CRM, Vontiv CRM, things like that. And at that point, they will determine which software has more features for less price.
Right.
Right? Features that they need, of course. Then there are, like, I'm just adding one more thought, you know, like future. You know, they also think in terms of if right now we can go with this system, which is fulfilling our needs and
right.
it is cheaper, but they might decide to go with Siebel only because of the fact that they might feel that, hey, you know what, in the future, Siebel holds more promises.
Right.
So there are many reasons because of which, and we'll keep adding these reasons. These are not, this may be like not even the main three things. I'm just
right.
putting, you know, whatever comes to my mind, but there is a lot of thought process here.
Right.
It's a lot of work, they think. Okay.
Everything that could come down the line is discussed at this level, pretty much at the feasibility study.
Very good. Yes,
whatever,
that's right.
Whatever, in any dimension, it could outgrow, it could, what's going to be the budget for this thing in the future, what are our needs going to be, how our business is looking like, they forecast it.
What happens is, I'm going to give you a very high level scope idea.
Right.
Like this is how a scope document looks like. In fact, it's a very informal document, you know, it is just explaining that, you know, we need account management work, you know,
mm-hmm.
right? So provide ability to efficiently map the account creation and maintenance process functions. Just at a very high level, it is not a very scientific document either.
Right.
It is just saying at a very high level what all we might need. Access control, we would need these access control mechanisms. Responsibility, basically our guy has just explained it, you know, on the basis of responsibility position, he's put out a few words saying that this is what we would need.
Right.
Because he knows, how does he know all this? Because he knows Siebel gives them. I taught him all this. So in a way, this knowledge is with you guys. You know, these are the things that are required for a good sales process.
Right.
So he's basically pitching in Siebel. This guy joined at a very high level. He joined at the planning phase itself.
Right.
And he's giving the very high level scope discussions. He's making presentations to the business,
right.
explaining them how system helps. So at planning, you know, it's not only about scope, it is also about motivating the users. There is a lot of stuff involved, basically, you know. So let me make.
You know what? This is what the benefits, features, advantages, and the benefits.
Yes.
Features and functions are going to be for the having a system in your company.
Mm-hmm.
And if you have it, these are the benefits.
Correct.
Towards your sales. I mean, obviously, their VP or their CEO, they do understand. That's why they call you in the first place.
Correct.
But once you are there, you're still just boosting their motivation.
Exactly.
So you're working through the deal.
Yes. And actually, let me tell you what, there's another dynamic here. These program managers, obviously, you know, they need to keep these VP sales happy. So
right.
They have good relationship with VP sales. Within company, within Cisco, within Yahoo, within GE itself,
right.
This is the relationship they have. And they want to, because they get the budgets from them, right? So they get the budget from them and they want to, you know, so they always keep telling them what all good things they can do for them.
Exactly.
So then
they have to keep them motivated.
Yes, they have to keep them motivated.
The funds, this whole thing is scrapped out.
Exactly. Exactly. Same thing. So planning is all about that. You know, you basically make them happy. You make them, you know that the things are possible.
Right.
There are things that you will do for them. This is also another presentation that we made.
Right.
Okay. In this presentation, if you see, lead management is there, account management. We are writing everything that they might need. We are presenting it in such a good manner and telling the sale. One of our guys, as part of planning phase, or as part of feasibility study phase, he has basically told the sales department.
Right.
Okay, sales department, VP and all, he was making these presentations for them.
Right.
And these are the good presentations he made.
Right.
Okay, he's made these all, you look at this. These are all these things which is writing, you know, this is what you can do. So it's more like a sales pitch. The relationship between these guys and these guys. The IT department within Yahoo and sales department within Yahoo.
Right.
IT department within a company and the sales department within a company. I'm not talking about the sales pitch of these guys to these.
Right.
To the customers, okay?
Right.
Then comes a very important phase. They realize that, you know, that we need to go with Siebel, and that's when they start hiring BAs. BA comes in. Sometimes at this phase also they start hiring BAs. For example, our guy is a BA, and they hired him for doing feasibility study, motivating everybody regarding capabilities of Siebel, using a CRM as such, and things like that. As part of requirement gathering, one of the most important things that our guys do is make business requirements document. Not just our guys do. That's a very important job that any business analyst would do. Okay? Then he makes is the business process modeling.
Right.
Okay? Then business requirements document. Then business process modeling.
Right.
They do the business process modeling. They model the whole business process. They sit with the sales rep, try to understand how do you guys sell.
Right.
And as part of your training, I'm giving you a lot of information about how the business process should be modeled. And I'm giving you a very simple model that accounts are there, contacts are there, then they follow up, they create opportunities. But there are hundreds of variations. Every company you will work for, GE, Cisco, Picard, Microsoft, Yahoo, any company that you'll work for, Abbott Labs, you'll work for AT&T, Verizon, T-Mobile, any company you will work for, they will have a different product to sell, so their business process will be different.
Right.
So as a BA, you will be first modeling their business.
Right.
Okay. Then you will be making something called as business requirements.